Welcome to our 25th video on roots, prefixes and suffixes in English vocabulary. In this video, we are going to discuss the various words in English that are derived from the Latin roots tac and qui, both of which lend the meaning silent or quiet to their derivatives. As a mnemonic for the word root tac, consider an empty box of Tic Tac, the famous mints manufactured by the Italian confectioner Ferrero. Interestingly, the box was branded that way because of the distinctive sound of mints clicking against the container. But if there are no mints inside the box, there will be complete silence, howsoever much you shake it. And that's the cue. The phrase tic-tac means nothing and simply denotes the sound, or rather the absence of any meaningful sound. The word root tac and its variant tick both mean silence. And the most celebrated word based on the root is tacit. Since the root tacer means to be silent, tacit originally meant wordless or noiseless. Nowadays, tacit is used in a scenario where something is understood or implied without being stated explicitly. For instance, there was a tacit agreement between them that he would pay off the loan whenever he had the means. Tacit might also be used when something is taken for granted, like in this sentence. When he proposed to her, her blush was a tacit answer. A related word is taciturn. Taciturn literally describes someone for whom silence is a habit. That is to say that a taciturn person is reserved or uncommunicative in speech, and speaks little and is temperamentally untalkative. Then we have the word reticent, which most people consider as an exact synonym of taciturn. Well, reticent is indeed quite similar in meaning. The word literally means to remain silent. A reticent person does not reveal his or her thoughts or feelings readily. Now, this might be because one is habitually silent, like a taciturn guy, but might even be when one is exercising caution or restraint in disclosing one's inner self. Consider this sentence. The actor is extremely reticent about his personal affairs. Now, actors generally are very expressive and confident in making conversations, and they're certainly not shy. But they could surely be described as reticent when they refuse to make certain aspects of their life public. At this point, I would like to narrate a very interesting anecdote about the 30th president of USA, whose name was Calvin Coolidge, but was popularly known as Silent Cal because he hardly spoke. One of the many jokes that are famous about his taciturnity or reticence goes like this. A Washington socialite, a lady, once approached Coolidge and said that she had a bet that she could get him to speak more than two words in a conversation. To this, Coolidge, in his characteristic laconic or terse style, replied, "You lose," which was a reply of exactly two words, and so the lady indeed lost the bet. Moving on to our next word root, qui. This one you can't forget because the root means quiet, which is a common word in English. Probably one thing I would like to highlight here is the fact that the word quiet could be used as an adjective as well as a noun and even as a verb. Its use as an adjective is the most common, like when you ask someone to be quiet, you are instructing him or her to make little or no noise. Though quiet can also be used in a second meaning. It can be used to describe an activity that is carried out discreetly, secretly, or with moderation, like in this sentence. Her fiancé wanted a quiet wedding. As a noun, quiet means silence or calm. For example, I can say that I need a little peace and quiet in this room because I'm trying to study. And one sentence where quiet is a verb, the sight of the stern principal in the doorway quieted down the kids. Related words are quietude and disquietude. While quietude refers to the state of stillness, calmness and quiet in a person or place, in short, the quality of being quiet. For instance, after crawling around the whole house, the toddler lapsed into an exhausted quietude and fell asleep. Disquietude will obviously be the absence of quiet, as the prefix dis is known to form opposites. If your mind is not settled or quiet, you are probably in a state of uneasiness or anxiety, which is what this word means. For example, as updates on the terrorist attack on Hilton poured in, her disquietude only increased, and she prayed for the safety of her husband who was staying there. Next word based on the root is quoi. The word has come from Latin to English via French and is a phonetic spelling of quoi. Only the meaning got changed over time. Quoi is used to mostly describe a woman who is pretending to be shy or modest, and often to attract attention or to appear attractive. For instance, she responded to his dinner invite with a coy smile. In a secondary meaning, we use the word coy when someone is reluctant to give details about something which is regarded as sensitive. Like we can say that when asked about her age, a woman generally gives a coy response. Coyness is the related word, which would be a noun. Our next word is quiescent, which literally means to be still or quiet. The word quiescent describes something that is in a state or period of inactivity or dormancy. Like probably an inactive volcano could be called a quiescent volcano. Here is a picture of what it looks like. And while the origin is not certain for the word tranquil, which is again very common in English, it is very likely derived from the same root quiet. Tranquil describes a state when there is peace and quiet all across. When something is free from disturbance or is calm, it could be called tranquil. The related noun is tranquility, and an example sentence would be, "The island is a tranquil place where fitness enthusiasts like to perform their yoga routine to find inner tranquility." Again, one of the popular words that feature in most exams is acquiesce. The word is made up of prefix ad, meaning to, and quiescere, meaning quiet. So the word literally means to be quiet or silent, and the word is generally used in situations when you quietly accept something without objection, though inwards you might be reluctant. A related word would be acquiescent, which is used as an adjective to refer to a person who is ready to accept something without protest or to do what someone else wants. An example to highlight the usage of both words would be, "She was an acquiescent subordinate, meekly following all her boss's decisions and commands, never arguing or protesting." Apparently, when they handed her the pink slip, she was expected to acquiesce, which means agree in that unfavorable decision as well. The word acquiesce is sometimes wrongly used as a synonym for agree. Like if I say the kids readily agree to their parents' suggestion to go for a movie, can I also say the kids readily acquiesced in their parents' suggestion to go for a movie? Well, we should not, because the word acquiesce implies agreeing to something, though inside you are reluctant. To acquiesce is to exhibit acquiescence, which is another related word and is a noun. And a last word that is derived from the root is requiem. Derived from the Latin requies, meaning rest, and just like we use the phrase rest in peace in memory of the dead, requiem is also a word that refers to a Christian religious ceremony for a dead person. Requiem is a mass for the repose of the souls of the dead. Like in this scene, we can see a requiem being held for King Louis XVI in France. By extension, the word might also be used to refer to an act or token of remembrance. For example, Shah Jahan built Taj Mahal as a requiem, that is, as a token of remembrance for his deceased wife. Now test your understanding of the words learnt in this lesson by filling in the blanks below. It is recommended that you pause the video when the timer starts. And that brings us to the end of this video. Hope you liked it. Subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.